So in the current account, various categories of trade and transfer which happens across the country, we will take into account. It could be visibles or invisibles. So transactions can be divided into visible items. Visible items in the sense machinery, raw material or technology, whatever may be the goods you are importing into the country, exporting into the country, to other countries, it is called visible transactions. And invisible means maybe services, all kind of banking services, insurance services, it comes under invisible account. And transactions may be unilateral or other payments. Unilateral means maybe if your family or your relatives are staying in other countries, you are sending money to them, or maybe in a kind of gift, or maybe any kind of money you are sending to them, that is called unilateral. It is related between the individuals. The transactions are made by the individuals, then it is called unilateral. Other payments or other receipts comes under another category. So in this way, in the current account, we can see the transactions of visibles, invisibles and unilateral, and other kind of payments also we can see. So this is called balance of trade, this is called current account. Then the second component is capital account. All the capital transactions between the countries are monitored in this capital account. It includes purchase of, sale of assets. So it is explaining about the sale of the assets and as well as purchase of the assets of non-financial in nature. Maybe a land or property we are purchasing in the other countries, a property, or we have invested land or maybe property in the other country. So it comes under assets value added, receipts are added in the receipt side of the balance of payments. It includes flow of taxes, purchase and sale of fixed assets, maybe migrants are moving out of the country or maybe they are coming into the country. So through these migrants, any kind of purchase is going on, any kind of sales is going on of the fixed assets, that assets amount transactions are calculated in the capital account. The deficit or surplus in the current account is managed through the finance from the capital account. So whatever may be the surplus is there, or whatever may be the deficit is there in the current account, that will be managed by the capital account, or that will be funded by the capital account here. So in this way, there are main three components, three elements are there in the capital account. So what are the things we will take into capital account means, first one is loans and borrowings. So whatever may be the loans we are giving to the other country people, or whatever may be loans we are taking from the other countries, will comes under the capital account. Both public sector loans are there or private sector loans are there which are located in the foreign countries. Maybe you have taken loans or borrowed from the other countries, or maybe you have given loans or borrowings to the other countries. So the transactions are taken into account in the capital account.